All right, thank you so much for joining us. My name is Willis Saburu. Now, 50 women members of parliament belonging to the Inua Mama group were installed as leaders in a ceremony in Uasin Gishu County. The women leaders, who are on a tour of Uasin Gishu and West Pokot counties, led by Gladys Boss Sholei, vowed to compete for their elective posts in order to increase the number of women in leadership.
Thank you. Today is a great day for these women here. Over 50 members of parliament that have met here at Mheshimiwa Sudi's home, where they have been installed as leaders. They have been given tools of power, and they are saying from today they are going to do whatever it takes to ensure that this nation will be led by a woman in the near future.
What the women have done today have installed us traditionally as leaders, because this is what we used to wash the calabash. But it's also a sign of leadership for women. It is the same as a rungu for men. And so they have given us the symbol of leadership. They have also given us this belt here, which is called a legetiet. Legetiet is what you give women who have had children, which is actually a sign of maturity, a sign of perseverance, and a sign of strength.
Tuko tayari kabisa kuosha uchafu ambayo iko katika taifa hili, ambayo ni uchafu ya tribalism, ambayo ni uchafu ambayo imewekwa na men chauvinism, ambayo ni uchafu ambayo imewekwa kusema ati wa mama hawezi ongoza, mama ambaye ako katika political leadership ati mama atakuwa ako na tabia mbaya. Sasa tunasema hiyo uchafu yote, as ladies we are ready to move on and start cleaning up our country.
And they have now sent us to war. We are going to take over this country.
Yes.
If you remember, Chelagat Mutai, the youngest and the only woman member of parliament who was elected, was from Uasin Gishu County. And she used to say, Tugatai. Tugatai means even when the cows are coming home in the evening, there is always a female cow ahead of the pack, which means women have always had leadership. We have just slept. Now we are taking over leadership. Kimi Tugatai.
These leaders, they are saying they are coming together as one so that they can fight in solidarity, supporting each other as women. And they are saying they are not going to support political affiliation.
We are not affiliated to any political party, because Bungoma is Ford Kenya.
But you know, after independence, something went wrong, because all the women leaders who were in the struggle for independence were actually not given any space in the political arena.
As they meet today at Central Primary School in Eldoret, Uasin Gishu County, one of the main issues that is going to play out is politics of Kibra, and that politics of 2022. They are saying that they are happy of what happened in Kibra, and they are saying this is an indicator of what also will be happening come 2022. After this particular main function here in Uasin Gishu, we have been informed that all 50 members of parliament, they will be heading all the way to Elgeyo Marakwet County, also where they are going to meet over 5,000 women, just to empower them, to give them machines to continue with their businesses for those who have skills. And they are also taking their 5 million Kenyan shillings just to ensure those women in groups, they are given those money so that they can start something to develop themselves.
Empowerment of women is empowerment of the nation. Empowerment of the girl child and the boy child is equalizing both gender, so that we can have a country that is well balanced, that is well governed, that actually respects equality and equity.
We're still following up on this particular story, and we'll keep you posted in our other subsequent bulletins so that you can get what is really happening in Uasin Gishu County and all the way to Elgeyo Marakwet. Back to your studio.
All right, thank you very much. That's John Wanyama, and like he said, he's keeping tabs on that story, and will let us know in our subsequent bulletins.